from its likelihood to whether SpaceX are the right people for the job and more. Join me as we explore whether SpaceX can get their Starship to Mars by 2024. The mission to Mars is without a doubt the mission of the decade. This is what many groups, including NASA and other international agencies, are attempting to create. One of those groups, though, is a privately funded one called SpaceX. And it's a team that is truly trying to go and get to Mars within the next few years. But to understand if that's even possible, you really need to know more about SpaceX itself. SpaceX designs, manufactures, and launches advanced rockets and spacecraft. The company was founded in 2002 to revolutionize space technology, with the ultimate goal of enabling people to live on other planets. While that may sound very basic, it's actually quite a complex thing. You see, for all the advances that humanity has made in regards to going into space, the fact of the matter is that it costs a lot to do that. So much so that the United States' main space agency, NASA, was hit with major budget cuts because the attempts they were making to revolutionize space travel just wasn't working. Enter Elon Musk, one of the richest men in the world, and a man who truly believes in trying to make space travel not just the future, but the present. He founded SpaceX in 2002 to try and make space travel better, cheaper, more accessible, and beyond. And as the SpaceX website loves to boast, since 2002, they've had quite a few successes. SpaceX has gained worldwide attention for a series of historic milestones. It is the only private company capable of returning a spacecraft from low Earth orbit, which it first accomplished in 2010. The company made history again in 2012 when its Dragon spacecraft became the first commercial spacecraft to deliver cargo to and from the International Space Station. SpaceX successfully achieved the historic first reflight of an orbital class rocket in 2017, and the company now regularly launches flight-proven rockets. In 2018, SpaceX began launching Falcon Heavy, the world's most powerful operational rocket by a factor of two. So as you can see, this is more than just a company. It's a place with a mission, and that mission is to get humanity into space, onto Mars, and more. And it's been working really hard to try and get a manned flight into space, and it's getting closer than you might expect. Why is that? Because Elon Musk, over the last several months and years, has been building various spaceships like we noted before. And in recent months, he's been testing the ones that he believes will send us to the planet Mars, including the line of ships he simply calls the Starship. The Starship architecture consists of a big spaceship called Starship, which Musk has said will be capable of carrying up to 100 people, and a giant rocket named Super Heavy. Both of these vehicles will be reusable. Indeed, rapid and frequent reuse is key to Musk's overall vision, which involves cutting the cost of spaceflight enough to make Mars colonization and other bold exploration feats economically feasible. You see, that's the big problem with going to Mars and trying to set up a home there. It's easy in concept. We just have to get there, set up a home, make sure it can withstand certain things, and self-sustain eventually. But with how things actually work, we're talking hundreds, thousands, even tens of thousands of hours trying to figure out all the potential problems that could happen on Mars before we even set foot on it. And of course, since things never go the way we think they will, it's going to inevitably turn into a thing where we're trying to make things work on the fly, or have to counter some big issues that no one saw coming. But if you think that is stopping Elon Musk from dreaming big and trying to get us to Mars and beyond, you don't know Elon Musk. Before we dive more into the big dreams of Elon Musk, be sure to like or dislike the video. That way we have feedback to improve our work, and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Musk wrote that the eventual goal is to launch each Starship vehicle 3 times per day on average. Each Starship will be able to carry about 100 tons of payload to orbit, so at that flight rate, every vehicle would loft about 100,000 tons annually, he explained. Now, Musk may sound like he's just spouting out a number here, and if we're being honest, he kind of is. But in truth, he's trying to abide by the laws of space and reality. What do we mean by that? Simple. When it comes to the facts of space travel, having the right windows to travel in are essential. Not the least of which is trying to minimize travel time by making sure you are in the correct windows. Confused? I'll explain. Think about the solar system we are in, okay? Think about how every planet orbits around the sun. Now, if you were to look at Mercury and its orbit, and then compare it to Earth's orbit, you would see quite easily that its orbit was shorter than Earth's by a very good margin. 88 days, compared to 365. So now compare the Earth's orbit around the Sun to Mars, 365 days to 867 days. Yeah, that's quite a leap. And because of that, the Earth and Mars aren't in the same alignment most times. Thus, Musk, NASA, and others are aiming to try and get people to Mars within certain windows. Building 100 starships per year gets to 1,000 in 10 years, or 100 megatons per year, or maybe around 100,000 people per Earth-Mars orbital sync, he said in a tweet. So for him, he's really thinking long-term by not just trying to get to Mars, but also trying to make it so when we get there, we have enough time and resources to make a true colony. We have the ships necessary to get a full colony made in a decent amount of time. By decent amount of time, I mean about 50 to 100 years. Yeah, this is not a quick process. However, the quicker we get started, the quicker we get done, right? And that's one of Musk's biggest goals. Trying to do things now instead of hoping something will develop later to make things more speedy. Because waiting around just isn't good when you're trying to shape the human race towards its future. After hearing some of his numbers, he stated one fan asked if he was seriously stating that we could have 1 million people on Mars by 2050. His response? Yes. Obviously, that would go against his timeline we just spelled out in part because of how long it would take to make a colony that could house 1 million people and be both functional and self-sustaining. But hey, goals. And trust me when I say that these are just some of the goals that Elon Musk has going on right now in terms of pushing space travel. He's also trying to get his Starship ready so that it can make an around-the-moon voyage in 2023, which will be helmed by a Japanese billionaire, I kid you not. Elon is working with NASA on various projects meant to push space travel and more. In short, he's a busy guy, and we should respect his ambitions in terms of trying to get us into space and more. But let's be honest with ourselves for a bit. While it's true that Elon Musk is a very ambitious and downright revolutionary thinker, he has lived up to his gift of gab in the past by just making SpaceX and other ventures. We have to be honest with ourselves here in that getting to Mars and colonizing it is a whole other set of issues that Musk and his team will have to deal with as they happen. And timetables are very easy to break, as he knows very, very well. Just in the last year, while he's had many successes, like with the beginning of his Starlink program, he's also had numerous setbacks with his team's ships, including Starship. There were mechanical failures, leaks in terms of fuel, that caused massive fireballs on ignition, and of course, lost ships. They were hoping to get to manned flight soon, but now those have been pushed back because they don't want to risk the safety of everyone. And this is all the stuff on Earth that we're dealing with. Imagine getting into space and having to deal with stuff. It's true that the Starship will be able to handle a vast cargo load and still go at a good clip, but we're still talking months in space, even with orbital sync. The journey is going to be rough, and that means all sorts of potential things could happen before they even land on Mars. Of course, Elon knows that to truly help make things work, he needs to set the stage before anyone arrives. So he's going to send some heavy cargo ships to the planet before people set foot on it, and leave a bunch of things for them to use when the time comes. This is actually what is intended to happen in 2024. It's the cargo that's going to go first, not humanity. But once the ship lands and they get the clearance for the next phase, we'll be going to Mars. At least in small part at first. When we colonize Mars, we would need to have a base that would allow us to not just breathe, but also protect us from all the effects of the harsh Martian landscape, and ensure that we can live without the need for spacesuits. SpaceX is working on that as well. Their plan is to have a singular massive base to start the colonization with. The base itself will be 41 feet tall, 16 feet wide, and have three different airlocks that will allow the colonists to go from the inside to the outside with minimal change in air pressure. It's stated that the initial team of colonists would be about 6 people, which is fair for a first attempt at surviving on Mars. Obviously, you can't just start off with a large city. If it proves successful though, and there are no serious issues with the base in terms of air pressure, longevity and more, more bases could be sent. Ones that could connect to each other via pressure tubes, not unlike various sci-fi shows and movies have shown. These 6 people will have quite the task ahead of them. Mainly, they have to live on Mars and do all the research and testing before time runs out on them. More on that in a bit. They'll be given all sorts of equipment to do a wide variety of tests. For example, if we were to try and live on Mars, we would need food, right? Obviously, NASA or SpaceX, whoever gets there first, will send all sorts of rations to allow us to survive. But to be a true colony, we would need to be able to grow our own food, specifically plant foods. If you recall the movie The Martian, this is exactly what the stranded astronaut had to do in order to survive, and he was successful via some ingenuity and having the right components. So now imagine a better equipped and less improvised session of testing on that front. Should we find a way to grow plants via Martian soil, it could be a big deal. There's also the notion of mining. Mining on Mars is aiming to be huge for a whole host of reasons, not the least of which is that some of the materials under the dirt of Mars could be beneficial to long-term survival via minerals that could power things, and even gold that could be sent back to Earth to help fund the expeditions that we're aiming to have there. Now, as for the time limit I mentioned earlier, the first set of people sent to Mars are only going to be there for less than a year. This is to help test things out, prove that various things work, and more. They're not aiming to push the envelope for once here. They want to ensure things get done, and they work, and that everyone gets home safe. Once they are home, they'll be tested, be sure that they are okay and are good to go for reinsertion to Earth, and so on and so forth. Those steps right there are very easy to say, but very hard to achieve, and both NASA and Elon Musk knows it. But that right there is part of the wonder and the mystery of space. Can we really do this? Can we really achieve everything that we want to do with this? Can SpaceX really get their Starship to Mars? It's a lot of questions, and with the potential mission being years away, it's hard to speculate. But if we do make this work, and we get to Mars, and we get the chance to make a colony there, it could change everything for humanity as a whole. Now, we wouldn't just be confined to one planet. We have multiple ones that we could live on over time. And once the first colony is made, more can follow. In truth, we don't know what is to follow, but you can't help but smile when you see Elon Musk pushing things to try and get them done. Because when he gets them done in one fashion or another, he'll be the first to say, "I told you so." Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of this look at SpaceX and the mission to Mars? Do you think that Elon Musk's plan to get to Mars by 2024 will succeed? What do you think will be the potential pitfalls of the plan, if any? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to like or dislike the video, and I'll see you next time on the channel.